Hey everyone, Jack here from Nexus Mods, and welcome back. In this episode, I'll be showing you how to install Vortex, connect your Nexus Mods account, and get you ready for the fun part, modding your games. Let's have a look.
If you downloaded Vortex using the instructions in our last video, which you can find a link to in the description, you should have it saved on your computer, probably right here in your downloads folder. Start the installer by clicking on it and selecting Install. We'd really recommend at this point that you install Vortex on the same drive as all your games, as some games won't play nicely if they're installed on an external drive, for example. Once it's completed, you should have a shiny new Vortex icon on your desktop. Click on it to fire it up. Once it's loaded up, you'll see this, the Vortex dashboard. It looks pretty empty at the moment, but don't worry, we'll soon fix that. To link up your account, click this icon in the top right corner. That'll open up your web browser and bring you to the Nexus Mods website so you can log yourself in, or if you don't have an account, set one up and join our community.
Now all you have to do is choose which game you're going to mod first. Vortex will take care of all of your games, called managing them.
To tell it what game to manage, click on the Games tab on the left, which will show you all the different titles Vortex is capable of managing for you. Choose the one you want to mod. For this video, I'm going to use Fallout 3 as an example. Some games, particularly ones made by Bethesda, so that's The Elder Scrolls, Fallout, are going to give you this notification, letting you know that you have to boot the game up first before you're able to mod it. If you do have to, then quickly start it up, close it, and come right back. I'll wait. So now that's out of the way, you can see we've got a whole new notification. You'll get these a lot when adding new games, but there's nothing to worry about. This one's just telling us to install the script extender. These are game specific, but it's pretty normal to have to download some kind of base plugin before you can throw lots of mods at a game. Just go ahead and hit download. It's always worth reading through your notifications, because quite often, if you're having issues with a mod not working, there'll be a message here to let you know why.
And that's all there is to it. Your game is now ready to be modded. And in our next video, I'll be showing you exactly that. How to install and deploy mods through Vortex. It's really simple, but in the meantime, don't forget to hit subscribe, ring that bell, and check out some of our other videos to get an idea of what you're going to be able to do very soon. See you around.